Hello, my name is Roy Laverty. I'm a principal engineering technologist for PowerFlex. In this video, I will demonstrate a recent enhancement to the PowerFlex SDC, which enables an automated compilation of the SDC driver on Linux compute nodes. SDC on-demand compilation addresses issues with the SDC driver failing to load because of an upgrade to the Linux kernel application binary interface. The PowerFlex Linux SDC installation package comes equipped with SDC drivers, each specifically pre-compiled for a particular Linux distribution and kernel. The SDC installation package includes a script called load driver, which checks the kernel version and loads the matching SDC driver. If the SDC driver fails to load due to a mismatch, the driver sync script will attempt to prefetch the perfect match SDC driver from a remote server. If a perfect match SDC driver is not available, driver sync will try to load the best match SDC driver. And if the best match driver fails to load, then the SDC service will fail to start. This is usually observed in Ubuntu Linux distributions because Ubuntu requires an exact match SDC driver. Starting from PowerFlex releases 3.6.3 and 4.5.2, SDC on-demand compilation is available. By integrating this feature with driver sync, your Linux compute systems will consistently have a compatible SDC driver. This combination ensures seamless operation and up-to-date drivers for your systems. By integrating the PowerFlex SDC's driver sync and on-demand compilation features, you can maintain compatibility with Linux kernel updates on compute nodes. For instance, during the verification testing of a new Linux kernel, the corresponding SDC driver can be compiled. After the testing phase, the Linux update is made available in your internal repository, and the updated SDC driver can be pushed to a PowerFlex SDC repository. To automate the SDC driver update, configure the driver sync feature on the Linux compute nodes. When the Linux update is deployed to the compute nodes, driver sync will detect any discrepancies and retrieve the updated SDC driver from the remote repository. This ensures your system stays up to date with minimal manual intervention. Now let's see this in action through a demo. I have logged into a Linux Ubuntu system, and we'll check to see that the PowerFlex SDC is installed and active. The Ubuntu kernel version is 5.15.0-94. Now I'll proceed to do an upgrade of the Ubuntu distribution. Upon completion of the upgrade, I will verify the kernel version. The kernel has been updated to version 105 from the previous version 94. Next, I will examine the status of the SDC service to find that it has encountered a failure. The failure was due to the load driver script's inability to locate a compatible driver. To gain further insights, I can employ the journalctl command targeted at the SDC service. The output from this command reveals that the process of verifying the kernel version and indicates that it failed to load either an exact match driver or a suitable alternative driver. Also notice the driver sync error messages. This is because this system does not have driver sync enabled. I am now set to initiate the process of enabling the SDC auto compilation feature. As a first step, I will ensure that the relevant Linux headers corresponding to my kernel version are properly installed. Subsequently, I'll proceed with the installation of the GCC and make packages. With the necessary packages now installed, my next step is to activate the SDC auto compilation. This can be achieved by generating an empty file named build driver in the /etc/emc/scale/io/skinny_sync directory. Finally, I can start the SDC service, which will initiate the process of compiling a new SDC driver for my Linux host. The systemctl status command output shows that the SDC service is loaded and active. Events from the SDC compilation are logged to the driver build log, which can be used to debug issues with the compilation process. In situations where on-demand compilation is not preferred, an alternative approach would be to manually compile the SDC. Let's review the manual process using another Ubuntu compute node. I have logged into a second compute node running Ubuntu 22.04 and kernel 5.15.0-105. Next, I'll install the SDC. Here, the installation shows that the SDC failed to start. Next, I will view the log for the SDC service using the journalctl command. The SDC service shows that the SDC driver was not a match and that the perfect match could not be found. The manual compilation process requires the same prerequisite in Linux packages, which are already installed on this Linux node. The next step is to copy the SDC tar file to a temporary directory and extract the contents. To manually compile the SDC for this host, I will run the build driver command, which was included in the tarball. The new SDC driver is placed in the INI directory and needs to be copied to the driver cache subdirectory. This subdirectory does not exist, so I will create it now and then copy the new SDC driver to this location. With the driver copied to the appropriate location, the service can be started. This concludes the demo on the on-demand SDC compilation feature. Thank you for watching.